Hola, 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 buenos dias, good morning, beautiful, welcome back to the channel. It's your girl here, Daniela, and your boy, Bugs the Pug, my cutie. Oh, he's so cute. I also have Daisy the Pug here. She's a little bit more wild. Daisy the Pug, oh, so cute. My babies have joined me for this video, but hello everyone, how are you doing? Let me know how you're doing in the comments down below. I would love to know. Love chatting with you all in the comments. I love chatting with you all in the comments. It's my favorite part of making videos, so please don't stop and drop a comment down below. Just letting me know how you're doing, how your weekend's going, what are you up to this weekend? Let me know. As for me, I'm kicking off this vlog in Sedona, Arizona. I woke up in Sedona, Arizona. Well, technically I'm in Cornville, which is about 20 minutes out of Sedona. We booked our Airbnb super, super late, so we weren't able to get a good Airbnb within Sedona's city limits. But honestly, it's kind of the move to book the Airbnb a little bit outside of Sedona because inside Sedona is so expensive. But I'm currently in my bedroom in the Airbnb. People are just waking up right now and we're getting ready to head out to Sedona. And I'm gonna be vlogging today and take you along with me to show you the beauty and splendor that is Sedona, Arizona. Sedona, Arizona is one of my all-time favorite places in the entire world. Ooh, had to close the door because people are waking up, making a little noise. And the microphone on my phone is really, really sensitive and picks up a lot of the background noise. Anyways, I'm so excited to share with you one of my favorite places in the world, Sedona, Arizona. It is gorgeous. And if you haven't had the fortune to visit Sedona, Arizona, I hope you enjoy this vlog so that you can see a little bit of the beauty of the city. We don't have any set in stone plans, but we're planning on going hiking, maybe do a few miles, and then we're thinking of hitting up the town, maybe hitting up the shops, kind of checking out like the main street in Sedona, getting some lunch, and then potentially going off-roading a little bit. Right now, I'm here with my boyfriend, Steven, one of my best friends, Ethan, and Ethan's friend and coworker, Freddie. And we drove up in Freddie's kind of lifted Tacoma truck, and so we're able to go off-roading a little bit, so we might go off-roading a little bit. And of course, I'm here with the pugs. And I think after the first couple of hours of hiking, I think we might come back here and drop the pugs off because they can't really hike more than 6 or 7 miles at this point. When Bugs was about 5 years old, he could hike up to 18 miles. I think that was the most that we ever did together. But he's 9 years old now and he can't really do more than 6 or 7, I would say. Daisy probably could do a lot more. She probably could do 18 miles, but I don't want to take Daisy and not take Bugs. So they're going to get some good hikes in, but we're going to come back and drop them off. I'm really, really excited for the entire weekend. We're going to be in Sedona for the entire weekend. And then on Monday, we're heading up to the Grand Canyon for a day or two. And then we're going up to Utah to Zion National Park. And I'm going to be vlogging every single day because I just need to share the splendor that are these places. So those are the plans. I'm really, really excited for the rest of this weekend and the rest of this trip. And I'm really excited to share with you my adventures and just like the beauty that I see when I go to these places. I'm a big national park person. I'm a big, you know, road tripper and adventurer. And I always see these beautiful landscapes, these beautiful vistas. And I've really come to realize that I really want to share those scenes and those places with people and those experiences. So I think this is a great way of just sharing that beauty with as many people as I can. So I hope you enjoy it. And because this is a planner channel, I just quickly want to share with you the planner supplies that I brought with me on this little trip. Honestly, I didn't bring a lot because there was 4 of us and 2 pugs squeezed into a Tacoma. And we did put a lot of stuff in the bed of the truck, and I probably could have brought more stuff, but I'm really trying to minimize how much I pack. I tend to overpack, especially planner stuff, and half the time I don't use it as much as I thought I would, and so I'm just carrying around all this paper and this weight. And I wish I had a little bit more time to do planner stuff and crafty stuff, but a lot of the times I just don't. And I'm really starting to realize that after multiple trips of bringing tons of planner stuff and only using a fraction of it. So I've really downscaled what I bring with me on road trips. And this is all I've brought with me. This little pile of planner stuff is all that I brought with me on this trip. And this might seem like a lot. Some people don't even bring their planner, but I just had to. So I brought two planners with me. I brought my mini on the go. This is my 90s on the go. And this thing has definitely been an on the go planner for me because I am on the go quite a bit. And honestly, this planner is a little bit ugly. It's a little bit ugly because I don't take a lot of care to decorate it. It's more of like a brain dump space for me. Write some quick notes, make sure that I have it written down somewhere, and then when I'm able, I go back into this planner and kind of transcribe it and move it into some of my more main planners. But I use this planner to just write a bunch of notes, so that's an example of writing notes. This is an example of a monthly, very, very minimal. And some weeks I do decorate this planner, like that week I decorated, some weeks I don't. It's just straight up notes. For a couple of weeks, it's just straight up notes. And some weeks, of course, are busier than others. So in this case, I decorated half the spread and then the other spread, the half I didn't do. And then some weeks I'm really in here, I'm decorating, I'm writing. I use the monthly overview pages as a place to write notes. Sometimes, again, I'm really in here and then sometimes I'm not. Oh, look at this one. Yeah, so I brought my mini on the go. I'm gonna use that as a place to write down, you know, things I've eaten, hikes that we did, just all the information that I like to put in other planners. And then when I'm back home, I'll go ahead and use this as like a template to fill in my plan and journal in my other planners. I brought two sticker books because of course I had to bring some sticker books. I brought teeny florals and Wrong Wrong Every Day. This is the mini one. I thought it would be so fun to pull for this teeny florals. This is one of the last sticker books I picked up before my shopping ban. I got it on clearance at Joann's and I thought it would be perfect for spring. And because it is officially spring, I thought it would be so fun to finally dig into this. And also I wanted to bring a mini sticker book because I am using my mini planner. And I thought it would be fun to go ahead and just decorate like the next couple of weeks, like all of April, maybe even all of May in my mini planner. This is the April divider and then the May divider. Because I tend to not decorate this planner because I don't have time. As you saw, like a lot of the pages were just not decorated. So I'm thinking that now that I'm on this little vacation here, I could just spend some time decorating the pages for the next 2 months and not worrying too much about it and just, you know, decorating when I can. And that way my mini planner is all decorated for the next couple of months. And then I also brought my Cafecito Designs planner. This is her vertical planner. This thing is so cute. Oh, I added my little kawaii concha sticker on the back. I love how it turned out. I brought this because I definitely want to be vlogging and thinking about the content that I want to create when I get back home. And so I wanted to bring this with me. I love it so much. I just put in all of the like the March monthly kit stickers from her subscription box. Super, super cute. I've really been enjoying this planner. Very cute. Oh my goodness. I've also been kind of neglecting this planner for the last few weeks, so I want to go back and just kind of work with this planner, journal about what it is I want to do content-wise for the next couple of weeks, brainstorm. I always find that on road trips, I'm very, very creative. I come up with lots of ideas about content I want to create, and I think it would be perfect to have this planner close at hand so I can just write down all of my thoughts. And then in terms of like pens, I brought my cute little kawaii pen case that I got in Little Tokyo. This thing is adorable. And this is honestly the pen case I bring to work. So it just has a couple of clean color dot markers and some mild liners. My trusty like pantheon of trusty black ink pens. So my Sharpie S gel. my Pilot Precise V7, I have a mechanical pencil, and my Pilot G-Tech C4, and of course I have, I just realized that I have both of my, like, multi-color pens. I have this dinosaur one and my pig one. Oops, didn't mean to bring both. And then I also have my Rilakkuma pen here. I always bring this Rilakkuma pen with me because the Cafecito Design stickers that I use in my Cafecito Designs planner, they really require like a certain type of pen, and this Rilakkuma pen is one of the pens that work with those stickers. I brought two washi tapes, one from Cafecito Designs and one from Simply Gilded. It's so hard to narrow down what washi tape you want to bring. And my Cafecito Designs a washi tape cutter. And that is all I brought for my planner stuff. So I'm really, really excited to get into it. Okay, I think we're gonna get ready to go soon here. So I'm gonna start packing up my bag. This is my road tripping bag. It is a Petunia Pickle Bottom diaper bag. I love it so much. I got it at a thrift store. And no, I don't have children, but I love diaper bags because they're just so organizational. They have so many pockets. They're really, really roomy. And I just love them for storing all my bits and bobs. So I'm gonna get my bag ready and I'm gonna go see if people are ready to go. And then we're gonna start vlogging the trip into Sedona. We're gonna drive over, it's about 20 minutes. And we're gonna get back into Sedona. So let's go get ready. I'm gonna start packing my bag. We have arrived here in Sedona. It's a beautiful day, not too cold, not too hot. I'm here with the famous Freddy. How are you enjoying Sedona, Freddy?
I hate it. I just want to go home. Not kidding. That's great. It's awesome. Got and Ethan.
This is Ethan's first time in Sedona. How are you enjoying Sedona so far, Ethan?
You know, it's there's a lot of colors in the rocks. I don't know what they're putting in the rocks to make them this color. It's a little sus. Other than that, everything's fine. So
perfect. You
know, just a rookie.
Just a rookie. Did Sedona live up to its hype that we hyped it up?
Definitely. I think the drive-in is pretty incredible. So, mm-hmm. And I'm excited to see the views.
It's amazing. We're right about to head on to the Soldier's Pass Trail. There's no parking at the trailhead, so we're gonna have to walk a mile to get to the trailhead. Sedona is super busy this time of year. I always come in December, and this is the first time I'm coming in March, and it's super busy, much more busy than in December. And the parking lot and to the trailhead we're going to is completely shut down, so we had to park like a mile away. And we're walking right now to the Soldier's Pass trailhead, about a 4 mile hike. We have the pugs with us, they're super excited, and the scenery is absolutely beautiful. Of course, Bugs had to stop and poop.
Red Rock soup.
This is like a huge sinkhole.
Go this way.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. What
are
they dance?
This is Jerry, that's Joey, and Grouch Man is Laddie.
Oh, wait, could you flip it and then do a video, please?
I'm filming right now.
Oh, but yeah, but like horizontal.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right, guys.
Have fun.
Have fun.
Oh, my gosh.
Have fun. Such good boys. And we're back from the hike. It was amazing. Actually, a lot of time has passed since we finished the hike. So we finished the hike and then we drove back to the Airbnb to drop off the pugs because they were getting tired. And now we just went for a nice scenic drive around Sedona. And we're just gonna go head to the shops after this and then get an early or a late lunch, early dinner. But it is gorgeous out here. Let me flip the camera around and show you. Cathedral Rock in the distance right there, it's gorgeous. Now they're taking photos of each other. Okay, we're here at Bell Rock and the courthouse. This is the courthouse. This is Bell Rock over here. We're taking one last jaunt to walk off all that pizza and cannolis that we ate. And just after this hike, we'll call it a night and go back to the Airbnb. Let's do it. We've made it to the top of Bell Rock. We see all of Sedona in front of us. It's gorgeous. Ready? How do you feel being on the top of Bell Rock looking at Sedona, Ethan?
I want to go higher.
You want to go higher?
But I can't come back down.
You don't want to go as
I'll
high?
I'll just stay up there.
You want to go up there? Oh my goodness. Hi. I am in bed and I'm exhausted. We got home, we watched 310 to Yuma, had a good time, and now I showered. I'm here with Daisy, and I'm gonna pass out. Good night.